Alright guys, welcome back to LoS's Worldcast. I'm here with Superior Sosa, as I like to call him. And we're going over Easter eggs and certain things of aspects of these Marvel movies and the Marvel Cinematic Universe that we love and hate. And this guy right here, who is my go-to, he'll ruin a movie for me, let me know everything. The guy's been 100% on every movie that I'm going to say, watch for this, watch for this, watch for this. So right now we're going into the second movie that's already been out, but maybe some things that you guys didn't know. And we're going into Thor 2, The Dark World, starring, you know, Chris Hemsworth and an amazing supporting cast, Natalie Portman.
Sir Anthony Hopkins.
Our boy Odin. Now,
Loki, of course.
And Loki, a dude's good. I think Loki can carry his own movies or series, maybe something like that. Thor 2. Thor 1 was loaded with Easter eggs, with secrets, the things that will tie in into the whole, when this thing wraps up in 2028, or whenever they decide to end this multi-billion dollar franchise, or you know.
It'll never end.
I don't think it'll ever end. What Thor 2 did for me is I did a little research. I learned about the ravens. Mm-hmm. You see two ravens throughout the movie. You'll see a raven that reports back to Odin. And these ravens report what?
They're in the Avengers too, by the way. When Loki and Thor are talking on the mountaintop, you see the ravens fly by. But basically, the ravens are Odin's eyes.
They report back on the nine realms.
Everything that they see, because Odin can see everything they see. Basically, they're his eyes.
Mm-hmm. All right, give me a real... maybe something deep that people didn't know about Thor 2 that's an Easter egg that leads into, that ties in the other movies. Maybe something that people missed. It was right under their noses. Something that that really, really tugged on you as far as you being a purist and a Marvel.
Well, the best thing about Thor 2 is that, again, we have another Infinity Gem. Now, you'll see
ether,
them reference...
right?
Yeah, the ether. You see them reference as stones, but that's another argument for us fanboys to have while the mainstream audience are just looking at trailers. We care about little things like that. So I'm going to call them gems because I've always called them gems. But again, they're called stones, so I don't want to hear anybody in the comment section try to fight me on this. I know what they're called, but I call them gems, so I'm going to call them gems. The ether. We see the ether. It's one of the gems because it's referenced by the Collector, which is another Easter egg.
Played by Benicio Del Toro.
Yes, and he'll be in Guardians as well.
Yeah. His character kind of was so weird, the painting of the lip and stuff like that. I didn't know how that might go over.
He played it weird, you know what? But I trust in Benicio Del Toro. This actually shows that Marvel cares about the acting because they go after the high class.
They pay a couple dollars.
They get the best.
Robert Downey Jr. might be breaking the bank on the next one. He's what, $50 million a film now?
Man, he's worth it, right? He's getting part of the box office take. Like that.
The royalties.
Yeah, he's getting a cut. But he signed on through Avengers 3. But another good Easter egg for Thor 2.
Thor 2, The Dark World. Give me something good.
Again, this is just something that you see, and you'll probably be like, okay, Loki's on the Asgardian throne. But what people don't understand is that, remember in Avengers, Loki made a deal for the Tesseract. Now he's sitting on the throne of Asgard with access to unspeakable type of Easter eggs in Odin's vault.
On top of that vault.
He's in Odin's vault.
Vault.
And now he can just do as he wishes with them. So be prepared to see the Tesseract and the Gauntlet, which is also in the vault.
Tell some people what's in that vault.
That vault in Thor 1, you see a lot of good pictures, and they released a lot of...
People slowed it down.
Yeah, they released a lot of screenshots of it. And in the screenshots, you have, let's say, the Gauntlet for one. The Infinity Gauntlet. The one that Thanos needs to control the universe. It's in there. Now the Tesseract is in there.
Mm-hmm.
You saw that the Coffin of Eternal Winters, that was the driving point of Thor 1, was in there.
The Coffin of Eternal Winters, which was wanted by the Ice Giants,
yes.
Correct?
But also, if you didn't notice, there's a Doctor Strange Easter egg in there.
Ooh.
So... again, spoiler, if you're not somebody who knows what I mean when I say the Orb of Agamotto is in there. There's also the Eternal Flame, which is actually a lead into what possibly could be Thor 3 and Beta Ray Bill, so look out for that. Yeah, there's just a bunch of stuff. I know I'm missing a couple, but... there's a lot of Easter eggs in there, so make sure you go in there and watch.
Well, hey man, that was good enough, so hold on real quick. We'll move out of Thor 2, which I thought was one of the top Marvel movies done so far.
I feel like they did what they should have. They got director Alan Taylor from Game of Thrones, and they really grounded Asgard in this medieval, spacey world that, mm-hmm. that really Nordic. Got bought into. Yeah,
mm-hmm. yeah, they sold it. And that camera shot where they lead into Asgard was just beautiful. Yeah. I think everything was just done so... It was so heavily detailed, yeah. you had to really respect the movie. You know, the carvings and the wall and stuff like that. I think they really knocked it out the park. So, Thor 2, in my eyes, gets an A+. Going back to the other video, Iron Man 3, I give it a B-. But this movie I'm going to be talking about now, which was is blowing up, which is still in theaters right now.
Iron Man 3, B+.
B+, okay. Captain America 2, The Winter Soldier, which reintroduces Bucky.
Hail, Hydra!
Who died in the first one, falling off the train. I don't know if you people remember, because people kind of passed on Captain America 1. It was a timepiece, as you call it?
It was a timepiece.
It was a timepiece.
Kenneth Branagh really brought a... Not Branagh. Was it Branagh who directed Captain America 2? I mean, Captain America 1? No, it wasn't. It was, No, it was Branagh.
Sorry, we can correct it.
I'm going to say Branagh. Branagh did bring a period piece, a 1940s superhero movie.
Mm-hmm.
And they named it The First Avenger, and a lot of people criticized it as being just a trailer for the Avengers. But I saw it for what it really was. Yeah, I saw it for what it really was.
I thought it was
an intro to Captain America in his comfort zone, because for the rest of the cinematic universe, he won't be in that comfort zone again.
Ever. Gotcha. And they really showed him at the end. He really wasn't. He ran out into Times Square. Which is kind of weird. He was really close to Times Square.
Where he's trying to find his spot in Cap 2. Where he's trying to find where he fits in.
When you left.
It's destroyed.
Yeah. All right, so in Captain America 2, give us some Easter eggs.
Okay. So, Hail Hydra, by the way. Let's just go to the meat and potatoes. Hydra. But more importantly, Baron Von Strucker. And let's say the Age of Miracles, because we all saw, again, spoiler alerts. If you haven't seen the end of Cap 2, go see it. Spoiler one more time.
Talk about it. It's already been out, man.
There is shots of Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch, who are referenced to as the Age of Miracles, which is a mindfuck all in its own.
Mm-hmm. Because Scarlet Witch is what, magic?
Scarlet Witch is a mutant. So is Quicksilver. But since Fox owns the rights to anything and everything mutant...
Right.
They can't say
they call them miracles.
They call them the Age of Miracles.
Okay. So some people might not understand that.
Some people, again, as fanboys like speculating, some people would say these are huge Inhuman references, where we will see the royal family and King Black Bolt of Adalan sometime in the future. But again, I'm just geeking out right now.
I have no idea what he's talking about.
No.
But anyway, so that was a big part of Captain America 2 towards the end. Was there anything that maybe stuck out with Tony Stark designing those weapons, all those carriers that went down?
There's a lot. There's an interview, not an interview, almost an interrogation of a S.H.I.E.L.D. agent, Sitwell,
mm-hmm.
where he's randomly listing off, or what appears to be randomly listing off, threats to Hydra. And in that list, he says Stephen Strange.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I don't know, again, geeking out a little, I don't know if this means that Stephen Strange is the Superior Supreme, the Sorcerer Supreme, pardon me.
Sorcerer Supreme, we have to learn.
The Sorcerer Supreme. Or if it's just a reference that one day he will become the Sorcerer Supreme.
Well, one day he will become the Sorcerer Supreme.
But how the hell does the computer know that? I guess, again, another reference to the Zola algorithm. I feel like that won't be the last time we hear that.
Ooh, I have no idea what he's talking about.
That may be part of Ultron. we saw that Arnim Zola wasn't dead, and they actually gave a great, great, great comic book depiction of him being saved in the hard drives or all those computers. That was pretty cool.
One thing I know, Chris Evans is only signed on for, I think, 3 more movies.
Here's the thing.
And Bucky signed on for 9. The guy that plays Bucky is signed on for 9. And the guy that died that they put on the bed is Crossbow. Crossbow kills Captain America in the Civil War.
Yes.
And Bucky takes over the suit. So that I do know. So help me out. What gaps have I
left
out right there?
That was pretty cool right there that you pulled that out of nowhere. Uh-huh. So if anybody familiar with the Civil War comics of Marvel that they did, it was a crossover event. Basically putting Tony versus Captain America.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of that, I won't get into it because if you haven't read it, it's huge spoilers. But
okay.
At the end of
it... In the future, we can discuss it.
Yeah. At the end of it, Captain America supposedly gets killed. And again, like all people in the Marvel Universe, someone who dies usually doesn't stay dead. But for this conversation...
Wolverine better come back.
Yeah,
I hate to jump on that.
That's pretty crazy.
Peter Parker
came back, you know, Superior Spider-Man's over, so we have Amazing Spider-Man. Mm. But, anyway.
Let's wrap it up.
Anyway, Captain America.
Mm.
Cap dies. Winter Soldier, Bucky Barnes takes the helm, and he dons the Captain America suit, and he probably will.
So the guy you saw way at the end when the credits all roll, Bucky, could be your new Captain America. We'll get right back at you. In the next video, we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about that. What are we going to talk about?
Probably Guardians. I don't know.
Guardians?
X-Men, maybe.
Amazing Spider-Man. Too. We got a lot to get into. Stay tuned, people.
Ultron already?
Yeah.
You already mentioned.